Alexis Tsipras, leader of Greece, 40-year-old, one of the youngest leaders of any country. He was the SFI leader there. For understanding his name, I have said that. In 1991, Alexis Tsipras, as a plus two student in his school, led their agitation against the reactionary reforms in the field of education. Occupy Wall Street is the name now most of us know, the world knows. But Alexis Tsipras and his friends in 1991 actually set the model by occupying schools. Their agitation was occupy schools. They remained in schools. They sat there. They ate there. And they developed some alternate education also by occupying the schools. He emerged as a student leader. He became a member of the Young Communist Party. Then I should tell the full truth. Today he is not a member of the Communist Party of Greece. They have formed their own leftist party. There our topic comes. The alternative would emerge from the left. The last election, Communist Party of Greece also improved its position. There is a Communist Party in Greece, KKE. Their seats, parliament membership enhanced from 12 to 15. But of Alexis Tsipras, his party got 149 seats in a parliament of 300. Yet I would also add, because many friends might have got all details. In Greece, the election process is very peculiar. Out of 300 seats, elections happen to, I think, about 250 seats. Once the results are published, the party who gets as a single largest party position, that party gets 50 seats more. That is how this result has come. There is a similar political leftist formation in Spain, Podemos. They are also gathering strength. So, communist parties, leftist forces, they are gathering strength in various European countries also. Everybody refers about Kerala, an Indian province where Communist Party and independence in 1957, undivided Communist Party alone could not get majority. There were independents, eminent independents like now you know Justice V.R. Krishnayyar, he was an independent supported by Communist Party. President Joseph Puttashedi, Dr. A.R. Menon, they are both elected. Together, Communists got a majority in 57. Now, in the land of Marx and Engels, a Kerala is emerging. Jungria, this is the name of the province. In that province, the reconstituted communist group, Greens, and various leftist forces, they together got majority to the provincial government. And there the provincial government chief is not chief minister, but prime minister. And members predicted that this communist leftist green movement alliance may get a majority. Then a leader of the reconstituted Communist Party leader would become the head of state, who is called a prime minister. So German Chancellor Angela Merkel during the election campaign stated that people beware, don't permit a new Karl Marx to become the Prime Minister of your province. That was her campaign, Angela Merkel's campaign. But people have decided that a new Karl Marx should be the Prime Minister of this province. I can add more information like this, which I don't propose to do. Now, the new communication material and all that, if you go to Google and search for the emergence of various leftist forces, performance of Communist Party, in Japan election, Communist Party improved its position. So left, progressive, democratic forces, they are merging in different parts of the globe. I would be failing in my duty if I add one or two points to the emergence of Syriza, the left force in Greece under the leadership of Alexis. What is the point I should add? He follows inspiration from communist leaders, though he has formed his own party, leftist party, which he claims is the genuine torchbearer of great values which Marx, Engels, Mao Zedong, Che Guevara, Rosa Luxemburg and others upheld. His inspiration is Mao Zedong. He is not a Maoist, but the so-called extremist. No. He has inspiration from Rosa Luxemburg. Women comrades should be happy, but there are not enough women among the gathering. That also is a no women, no woman, what is changed? We have to self-critically realize that. In the offices of Syriza, the party of Alexis, you would find photograph of Rosa Luxemburg also. And Alexis Tsipras gave the name of Che Guevara to his second son. Tsipras' second son's name is Ernesto. Ernesto's name has been given in honor of Che Guevara, which is very important. Then in the life of Alexis Tsipras also, there is some revolutionary behavior, which also I should share with you. He married a comrade whom he met in Young Communist League at the age of 13. They continued as friends. Then they have decided to live as husband and wife without having a formal marriage function. That is all cohabitation in modern days. And they have two children. They are building up a family. There was a question asked to Frederick Engels. What would be the man-woman relationship in a changing social situation? Or he was asked in communist society, what would be the nature and character and form of man-woman relationship? Frederick Engels gave a profound reply. Frederick Engels said, the man-woman relationship in communist society would be decided by the women and men who construct that society. We don't have to waste our time thinking about that. That will be decided by them. And Alexis Tsipras perhaps is trying to explore through his life experiments something what Engels was trying to communicate. Now we have to come a fast forward. Okay, fine. You have proved that in Latin America, in Europe and various other places, leftist forces are melting and they are developing their own experiments. In China, when the entire world economy is encountered with recession, stagnation, when the US economy is unable to show any remarkable recovery from the 2008 collapse, world economy is alive. World economy is alive because of the volatility, strength and life of Chinese economy. The growth of Chinese economy, it's not a fact. Among the major economies in the world, Chinese economy is growing the fastest. At some point of time, Chinese economy was encountering overheating. Now they are controlling that. But we have our own friendly critical observation about some of the features of the way in which Chinese society and Chinese economy is evolving. That is there. The details I don't have to narrate here. But then the question, somewhat difficult and complex question, we the leftist forces within India would encounter is, and you know what it is, I don't have to say that. Okay, left forces are emerging in Latin America, Europe, China is going strong.